Well guys, today we are going to talk about Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice. Hellblade is a psychological horror game with elements of action and adventure. Developed and published by Ninja Theory of Devil May Cry fame, the game looks really promising. So people, let's find out more about it. First thing first, let's talk about the game plot. The central character of the game is a young warrior named Senua, who has been banished from a village due to a touch of darkness. Essentially, this so-called touch of darkness is a mental disease called psychosis. And we must point out that the developer has tried very hard to justify and effectively depict the effect of psychosis on human brain. So eventually, when Senua returns to her village after her exile, she finds her village in ruins. And then she takes a figurative journey to redeem herself and to save her partner's soul. Hellblade's gameplay has many unique traits. Let's start off with the sound system of Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice. Senua's psychosis is in the center of the gameplay. She hears multiple conflicting voices in her head. And by her head, we mean your speakers and headphones. The voices sometimes guides her, sometimes the voices discourages her, and sometimes just mumble insignificant things. However, these voices are an inseparable part of the gameplay, and the game is most enjoyable with a good set of headphones and a surround sound system. As Senua advances in her journey, the number of voices in her head increases. Each and every voice contributes to the gameplay in some way or the other. However, it becomes increasingly difficult to concentrate on the game with all those voices playing around in your ears. Now let's get into a different aspect of the gameplay, which includes solving puzzles. The game is literally filled with puzzles. You need to find certain Celtic signs in the game environment and align them in specific ways to open pathways. These pathways will lead you to the next level of the game. This is where Senua's psychotic hallucination comes into effect, and we must applaud the developers for integrating the psychosis aspect of the game so seamlessly. All said and done, what about fights in Hellblade? The fighting system of Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice is fast and fluid. Fights are always staged in arenas, gladiator style. Senua has a specific style of fighting, and you get all those abilities right from the start, and don't expect to get radically different or new fighting styles as you advance in the game. The fights are the center stage of the game, and the fights are intense and the soundtrack is fabulous. As you advance in the game, you get increasingly difficult bosses to fight. And yes, there is not one but multiple boss fights in Hellblade. And each boss fight is unique in a different way. Quite frankly, you can buy this game just to experience the boss fights of the game. Which brings us to the graphics of Hellblade. Art and graphics of Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice is also one of the strongest aspects of the game. Well, most of the cinematic sequences of the game are performed by actors. The developer Ninja Theory actually demonstrated a portion of the game in GDC 2016 by capturing the actors' performance live on the show. This new technique is developed by Ninja Theory in collaboration with Unreal Engine creators Epic Games, facial tech specialist 3Lateral, and facial animation expert Cubic Motion. And the results that we see in the game are nothing less than spectacular. Well, the final verdict is, with cutting-edge facial recognition tech, advanced motion capture, an engrossing but peculiar storyline, and some really, really good and intense fight sequence, we think Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice is a game everybody should try out. But it may not be everybody's cup of tea, as the constant voices in your headphone and psychotic environment may be too hard to digest for some players. However, if you have a stomach for this kind of raw entertainment, don't ever miss it. Our rating for the game is very high, 9.5 out of 10.